Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Sheng Cheng. I am a PhD student from the University of Maryland. My advisor is Dr. Derek Paley. Today, I'm going to talk about our work on optimal control of a one-dimensional diffusion process with a team of mobile actuators under jointly optimal guidance. Currently, human operators conduct most of the work in monitoring and control of large-scale spatial-temporal processes, like forest fires or oil spills. This can be time and economically costly and dangerous to the operators. However, autonomous vehicles can replace the human operators in this situation when they're equipped with sensors and actuators. For example, in the case of forest fire, an unmanned aerial vehicle can have infrared temperature sensors and fire retardant dropping mechanism. In the case of oil spills, the helicopters can serve the mobile sensors. They may carry the cameras to detect the oil on the sea surface. The actuators can be the oil skimmers, which works as sinks. Now, to replace the human operators, the autonomous vehicles should also be guided to know where to go and how much actuation to implement. The actuation to a partial differential equation can be categorized by the mobility of the actuators. They could be stationary or mobile. For a stationary actuator, it can be placed at the boundary of the spatial domain. Representative approach is backstabbing, in which a Volterra transformation is applied to the controller design. The actuators can be placed in the domain, and the problem that studies where to place the actuators is called actuator placement problem. One major approach for the placement problem is optimization, where optimality in the sense of linear quadratic, H2, and controllability has been investigated. For mobile actuators, guidance needs to be designed to utilize the additional degree of freedom induced from mobility. Optimization can also be used to derive guidance, for example, linear quadratic optimal guidance. Another approach is Lyapunov-based, which is mainly contributed by Dimitriou in recent years. This approach devises a Lyapunov function with the PDE state and possibly the guidance of the mobile actuators. And then guidance is derived such that the derivative of the Lyapunov function is negative. Other approaches, like centroidal Voronoi tessellation, have also been investigated to derive actuator guidance. The contributions of this paper are summarized as follows. First, we formulate an optimization problem that looks for both the control input to the PDE and the guidance of the mobile actuators. And second, we prove the conditions under which an optimal guidance can restrict the actuators to stay within the spatial domain without constraints. Let's start with the setting of the problem. First, we assume linear dynamics of the mobile actuators. Here, C denotes the position of an agent, and P denotes the guidance. The subscript I indicates the index of an agent. A spatial-temporal process varies both in space and time. We choose a diffusion equation to model this process. Consider a one-dimensional diffusion equation with pointwise control implemented by the mobile actuators. Here, Z of X and T is the PDE state, which can be considered as the temperature or concentration. The last term characterizes that the control U of agent I impacts the diffusion process in a pointwise manner through the direct delta function. For a total of n agents, the control from each agent are added with gain D sub I. The animation on the right shows how it looks like when a mobile actuator implements a constant actuation to a diffusion process. The actuator tries to push the curve down, but the nature of diffusion always tries to smooth out the curve by pulling itself back to zero. For simplicity, we can write this dynamical system with an abstract linear system representation. Now, the calligraphic Z denotes the PDE state, which lives in a Hilbert space as the new state space. The Laplacian operator is denoted by calligraphic A, and the direct delta function and the gain is now compactly written as calligraphic B, with subscript C indicating the actuation happens at location C. Here, we want to emphasize the difference between guidance and control. guidance steers the dynamics of the mobile actuators, while control refers to the actuation input to the PDE. Now, with the linear system representation at hand, even though the state space is infinite dimensional, we can derive a linear quadratic regulator just like its finite dimensional analogy. The cost function is quadratic in the PDE state and control, with possibly a terminal cost of the state. A feedback optimal control can be synthesized with a solution of the differential Ricard equation that is operator valued. Let's look at the formulation of our problem. We want to find an actuation control U and actuator guidance P such that this cost function is minimized subject to the constraints by the dynamics of the PDE and the mobile actuators. The cost function has two terms. The first term associates with the PDE and is the quadratic cost of the PDE state control effort with a terminal state cost. The second term associates with the mobility and is the quadratic cost of the state and the guidance of the mobile actuator, with the terminal state cost penalizing the distance to the designed terminal locations. Notice that the control effort and guidance effort are used here to address the limited onboard resources. For example, in the case of taking out a forest fire, an unmanned aerial vehicle only has limited amount of fire retardants to drop, and the fuels or the batteries on board are also limited. In our problem formulation, we use quadratic costs to penalize overly spent actuation and aggressive maneuvers. Now, in this problem setting, we didn't restrict the actuators to stay within the spatial domain. But it could be a problem if the mobile actuators travel outside the spatial domain, because any actuation dispensed outside the domain cannot influence the PDE and hence is wasted. We don't want this to happen. So the theorem we show next is a special case that guarantees the optimal guidance can restrict the actuators within the spatial domain. Here's the theorem. Consider problem P with the following assumptions. First, the actuators have single integrator dynamics. Second, the state running cost in the mobility related cost is zero. And third, the initial locations of the actuators are in the domain. And fourth, either the terminal locations are inside the domain or the terminal cost is zero for the actuators. And then we can show that any guidance that steers the mobile actuators outside the domain is not optimal. And by contraposition, this is equivalent to say that under these assumptions, an optimal guidance can restrict the actuators within the spatial domain. Here we provide a sketch of the proof. We start from an arbitrary guidance that steers one actuator outside the domain. And then we can construct another guidance, which is identical to the first guidance, except that we flip the sign of the second guidance whenever the actuator hits the boundary of the spatial domain. So the second guidance can always restrict the actuators in domain. And in this way, the mobility related cost incurred by the first guidance will be equal or greater than that of the second guidance. And moreover, the first guidance will incur more PDE related cost due to a property of the infinite dimensional LQR. This result saves the effort and time to prevent the actuators go outside the domain, meaning that we don't have to add the constraint that the actuators have to be inside, because an optimal guidance of the proposed problem will guarantee that the actuators to stay inside. Now, to numerically solve the proposed problem, we use Galerkin method to approximate all the infinite dimensional components in the optimization. Now we have an approximated PDE related cost, J sub n, and a finite dimensional dynamics of the approximated PDE. Notice that this approximated problem is not an LQR. We may think of the state variable is concatenated by the approximated PDE state Z sub n and the state of the mobile actuator C. The nonlinearity comes from the fact that the approximated input matrix B sub Cn is a nonlinear function of the state C. And next, we shall use Potriagin's maximum principle to derive a dynamical system. Solving this system of equations will provide a candidate solution. Now, we derive the co-state dynamics of lambda and mu, which are associated with the approximated PDE state Z sub n and the location of the actuators C respectively. The terminal conditions and the optimality conditions can be derived also. The system of equations is solved using gradient descent method. Here we show a roadmap of the procedure of solving the proposed problem and also the solutions we can obtain. We start with the optimization problem P. We approximate all the PDE related terms with their finite dimensional approximation, and we got problem AP. And then we apply Pontryagin's maximum principle to solve for an optimal guidance and an optimal control. Notice that these two optimal solutions are all open loop. And then we can propagate the dynamics of the mobile actuator with the optimal guidance to get an optimal trajectory. With this optimal trajectory, we can synthesize a feedback control of the PDE using the LQR of the PDE. We shall see both optimal open loop control and the optimal feedback control in the numerical example shown next. Now, with the solution method at hand, we proceed to show a numerical example. In this example, we consider four mobile actuators that are initiated at the same location with evenly spaced terminal locations. Let me remind ourselves that the control refers to the actuation input to the PDE and guidance refers to the steering of the mobile actuators. Now, solving the approximated problem, we can synthesize a feedback control with the optimal actuator trajectory using the method introduced on the previous slide. We will consider four combinations of control and guidance for comparison. The first one, named optimal feedback, has the optimal feedback control and optimal open loop guidance. The second one, named optimal open loop, differs with the previous one for an optimal open loop control. The third one, named semi-naive, has an output feedback control and it follows the optimal open loop guidance. And the fourth one, named naive, has the output feedback control and it follows a naive guidance that steers agents at a constant speed to reach the terminal locations. In the simulation, we add a perturbation term which dispenses pointwise perturbation to the system. And we compute the costs in these four cases and normalize them with respect to the largest one, which brings us this table. As can be seen, the group of optimal feedback has the minimum total cost compared to the other three. And notably, this group incurs smaller approximated PDE related cost than the optimal open loop group. This is due to the capability of feedback. Here we show an animation of the optimal feedback control implemented by the mobile actuators that are steered by the optimal guidance. The locations and the actuations by the actuators are shown by the light blue star, whereas the control process is shown in this light blue curve. As for comparison, we show the uncontrolled diffusion in the black curve. And now this animation shows the comparison of the guidance, actuation, and the corresponding PDE in the four groups. The blue curve represents the process under the optimal open loop control. It almost coincides with the feedback controlled process in the light blue color that we just introduced. The performance in terms of bringing the diffusion to zero state is quite similar. The red and the green correspond to the semi-naive and naive groups. They can certainly bring the diffusion to a zero state, but slower than the other two optimal groups. Now on the top right, we plot the norm of the PDE versus time. The optimal feedback and optimal open loop behave similarly in the beginning, shown in the blue and light blue color. Then the feedback beats the open loop after 1.4 seconds. The two figures on the bottom right show the actuation input and the trajectories of the mobile actuators in the optimal feedback group. There is an obvious maneuver of the fourth agent who also contributes most of the actuation. You can also see this in the animation on the left. One explanation of this behavior is that this actuator meets the peak of the PDE sooner than the other agents. So it has to bring the peak down soon enough to save the actuation from other agents utilizing the nature of diffusion. To summarize, we proposed a guidance and control scheme that steers a team of mobile actuators to regulate a spatial tamper process modeled by a one-dimensional diffusion equation using the optimal control method. We solved the proximity problem using Pontryagin's method principle and gradient descent. Our ongoing work includes the following. We will extend this control and guidance framework to a diffusion advection process on a two-dimensional spatial domain because the interesting applications have spatial dimension that is more than one. The animation on the right shows our recent simulation of controlling a two-dimensional diffusion with the mobile agent. We will also consider more efficient numerical computation to seek for optimal solution of the proposed problem. One important problem that we want to study next is to show that the solution of the proximity problem converges to the original problem, which indicates the validity of the computed optimal control and guidance. And finally, we will look at the dual estimation problem with a team of mobile sensors and possibly conduct simultaneous estimation and control with a team of mobile sensors plus actuators. Thank you.